Hi everyone, and welcome back to another episode of Creating Change. My name is Jillian Walsh. I'm a registered dietitian as well as a registered psychotherapist qualifying here in Canada. And today I'm here to talk about all of the body's built-in safety nets when it comes to eating disorder recovery. So when you hear me talk about the built-in safety nets, I am often referring to the way that the body has kept the sustainability of the body going for so long. I get a lot of questions from families as well as folks that are living with eating disorders saying that, hey, I feel fine, my vitals are fine, so I must not be sick, or I might not be sick enough. And this is really, really tricky because those measurements that are taken as part of the vitals are really measures that are going to basically be masked due to the body's built-in safety nets. So what I mean by that is when somebody is steeped in an eating disorder and their body is in starvation syndrome. So don't forget, we just talked about that in a few episodes past. So if you don't know what I'm talking about, link on over there first. But what we're talking about here today is when somebody is in starvation syndrome, what happens is the body turns on all of these protective factors. I like to call them the built-in safety nets. And so what that means is that the body basically has this backup system to keep you alive longer, even though the body's not receiving fuel. So the main thing that happens is that the body's metabolism slows. Now, I'm not talking about metabolism as diet culture talks about metabolism. When I talk about metabolism, I'm really talking about the body's entire processes to keep us alive. I'm talking about digestion. I'm talking about beating our hearts, pumping our lungs, being able to move muscles, being able to regulate body temperature. So all of those things are part of the body's metabolism. So when the body's built-in safety nets kick in, what happens is that the body's temperature reduces or decreases. So it goes down. And the reason it does that is because the body has to slow metabolism in order to stay alive longer. This is why a lot of my clients complain about feeling cold, especially in their hands and their feet. So what happens is that the body's blood or the circulation starts to pool around our vital organs, which is all contained in our trunk as well as our head for the brain. So what happens is that all the circulation focuses in on our trunk section, leaving our hands and our feet quite cold. Now, another thing that happens is our blood pressure goes down. Again, that is how our body sustains itself despite not receiving enough nutrition. Another thing is the heart slows. So when you talk about vitals, the heart rate decreases. Now, the other thing that we hear a lot of is blood sugars. So again, when we're talking about the digestive system, when things slow, the absorption of glucose into our bloodstream also slows, which means that our blood sugar levels may also decrease. Now, if we're talking about slow digestion, then of course that might look like constipation as well. The entire digestive process will slow, which means that the transit time becomes much, much longer. And of course, the stool will be harder because the body wants to suck out every last nutrient before passing through the waste into the toilet. And then finally, this one is not necessarily common, but I've definitely seen it before. And so what happens with the body when it gets very, very ill, one of the last built-in safety nets to kick in is something called lanugo. And what that is a thin layer of hair all over the body. Sometimes it actually looks like fur. And the reason for that is it's the body's way to try and regulate body temperature, avoid hypothermia by basically creating this level of hair to just keep the body a little bit more isolated than it would be without. All right, folks, so those are all of the body's built-in safety nets that we are here to talk about. So to recap, really what we're talking about is how the body slows down metabolism in order to sustain life longer. This is in response to starvation syndrome. And what we see is a decrease in temperature, a decrease in blood circulation, a decrease in blood pressure, a decrease in heart rate, decrease in blood sugar levels, decrease in digestion or transit time, and finally lanugo, which is that thin layer of hair to help the body stay warm. If you have any questions about these built-in safety nets and you want to know more, drop some comments in the boxes below. And of course, these episodes will come weekly, so don't forget to subscribe to our channel. All the subscribers help me to know that, hey, somebody's out there listening and I need to keep doing these videos. And finally, make sure you hit the bell so you get notified of the next video release. Now, of course, we're really aiming for it once a week. Now, before you go, if you're left wondering where to go next, we actually have a free webinar that we do every month. It's hosted by myself. It's 2 hours long. And what I do is I teach live on topics such as first, do no harm. And what it's all about is teaching parents how to support their child who they may suspect has an eating disorder, and really gives them a roadmap to what to do next. So if you're looking for that, the link is going to be down below. We'd love to see you there, and our next one's coming up soon.